G'day guys, welcome back to our show, Star Wars Vault Unleashed. Today, I am so excited to welcome you to our episode 13. And we're going to meet a fellow collector, not only collector, but he also creates multiple rooms just for his passion for Star Wars. And I'm so excited to introduce you, Guillermo Olivo from Western Florida, over in the United States, and he's going to take us through his man cave. I can't wait for that. Guillermo, how are you?
How are you, Harry? Thank you so much for having me today. Thank you.
No, it's a pleasure and it's an honor to, you know, to have this time and to interview with you as well.
No, I mean, I'm super glad that you reach out and I would love to share. I'm not a camera person. I'm usually behind the cameras, but lately, for some reason, I've been asked a lot to be in front of a camera, and it is what it is. I at the same time, I love to share this passion that we, like you said, all across the galaxy. However, we have this glue, which is this passion for Star Wars in this case, but in my case, mostly collectibles that, you know, we bond and connect right away. That you have a very neat background yourself.
Thank you. But I'm sure it's not going to be as great as yours, but hey.
You know, it doesn't matter the size. It doesn't matter the size. It's what you feel. However, exactly. I've been watching some of your videos, and I think that I should do something. I hope you don't cut this. Let me do something. You're not going to be able to hear me for a second. Stay there. Stay there and don't cut the video.
Let's make this right. Let's make this proper.
You're not going to be able to hear me, but now we're on the same page.
Give me five.
We're on the same page now. We're going to take it off so I can put the headset back on. But now I saw that none of your guests have used, you know, I think it's cool. Like Red 5 standing in.
Guillermo, please do tell us a bit more about yourself.
Well, I'm a filmmaker. I'm a director and then mostly television producer, although we've been incurring, when I say we, because I see it as a pack, as a company, it's not just myself, but we've been incurring in short films and documentaries and in long format. And I've been doing this for a few decades now. Wow. Yeah, that's me in a nutshell, pretty much.
Cool. And seeing some of your profile out there, you know, you have produced some of the most featured documentary. It's called Plastic Crack, right? What is it all about? Mm-hmm. Do you want to tell us a bit more about that?
Plastic Crack is basically a journey to explore what we feel about collecting. It's what triggers a collector, what motivates a collector. When we started the journey of doing a documentary, I wanted to do something different. That there's a lot of good options out there, very good options that I'm even a fan of, that I've seen myself. So I wanted to take a different approach. So that in the brainstorm before we started pre-production, that came up. So why don't we cross the street and let's not talk about the lines. Let's not talk, although we do in a certain way, let's not talk in depth about the design or the creation of the line, although we do, but let's instead talk to the collector. What triggers you as a collector? How do you get to this point? And at the same time, I wanted it to be like sort of like a conduct to non-collectors, because we notice like we all have this clash with real life when we get to a point and someone finds out that we have rooms like yours full of toys and they go, what's going on with this guy? So at the same time, I was trying to make like an ode to collecting and trying to explain what's behind it and what type of that we are normal people, well, families and mortgages. And we just do this for different reasons, but we just do this for, you know, for fun. Some of us, when we walk into the room, become that 7-year-old kid and you forget about mortgage, you forget about issues, and you just go back to that time where you were 7. And everything was a happy life. And I believe that toys have that power. They're totems of creativity. They're totems of disconnect from reality. Not that it is a very needed, healthy thing, because some people criticize that. But if you can escape for a few hours from your daily journey. Why not? And I, at the same time, I think it's a healthy, if you control your finance, I think it's a healthy addiction, if you will. We call it plastic crack addiction in a fun way, but it's, I mean, it could be worse. I could be sitting in a bar drinking, you know? So we explore all that. That's pretty much plastic crack in a nutshell.
Great. And there you go, folks. You've heard it from Guillermo himself. You should check out Plastic Crack if you haven't yet done so. It's available on Amazon in multiple countries as well. So make sure you do check it out.
Thank you.
Tell us how you got into Star Wars and how you start getting the addiction towards Star Wars yourself.
Well, I guess I was at the perfect age. I was a very young kid in the glory years of 82 to 86, where we have not just the Star Wars, but the best toys ever made from my perspective. And Star Wars was, as everybody knows, a big phenomenon that pretty much changed the way we do films, the way we see pop culture. And I was very, very taken by it. I believe the first movie that I saw was The Empire Strikes Back, and I was very young, but the one that I clearly remember seeing was Return of the Jedi. And then eventually I got them all on VHS, and once I got them on VHS is when the actual fun started. But my main attraction to Star Wars was the toys. The toys were, even before even watching the movies, there's so magic with the yeah. Star Wars toys that I just got hooked. And the movies actually complemented my love for the toys.
Yeah.
So what I do for a living is mostly do and heavily influenced by Star Wars, because at the very, before I was 10, I was trying to replicate with a home camera, replicate the movie with action figures. And yeah. Star Wars was the only line that you can pretty much complete a scene with every single character without missing an element versus other lines. Like, you know, you pretty much, I used to like pause the VHS and then I go, well, I need five yeah. Stormtroopers on this one. So that's how the army building started at the same time. Like I was trying to replicate and mimic what I ended up aspiring to be a director because of George Lucas. And
wow.
I apply that, not at his degree, of course, but I apply that as much as I can. Like I'm a Joseph Campbell fanatic, and that's due to that influence.
So thank you very much for sharing that, you know, what actually inspired you to become a, you know, film director and producer. Talking about, you know, the toys back in the 80s, my first mm-hmm. one was, what got me into Star Wars was actually the Luke Skywalker X-Wing Empire Strikes Back, in the 80s.
Right? Yeah, that's funny.
What's your first one?
That was exactly my first one. My first action figure, was a Luke X-Wing pilot. I actually have a photo. I think I was like a year old, and I'm sitting down, and the figure right next to me is a Luke X-Wing pilot. But the ones that I remember the most playing with that I actually still have, and I'm gonna jump ahead and answer that question in advance. But my most valuable figures are a beater, R2-D2, and a C-3PO. That they're probably worth $1 each, but they're being with me since I was a very young kid.
All right, so Guillermo, without further ado, I can't wait for the audience, our viewers, to see your collection and your man cave. Can you please take us through it?
Sure, by all means, let me grab this thing. This is a cast of the original. There's a local artist working on it.
Wow.
This is still a work in progress. Like, you still need to finish the edges, but it's, you know,
it's awesome.
It's a great piece to have there. And then, and here's where I'm going to flip the camera. This is the Star Wars room, part of it.
Oh my gosh. Check that out, guys. Wow.
So I have, like, my centerpiece is this diorama, which is a combination of, like I was telling you, I like to recreate scenes and And that has been part of my gameplay from the beginning. Like, you know, these are not the droids you're looking for. And I don't mind mixing mixing vintage with modern. I have a little bit of everything in this place. And of course, the barge, troop buildings is up. But I love like things like this. So you can put, you know, the camera like this, and then it looks like a very big. You have no idea of the amount of times that I spend just with my phone, just putting the phone in places like, you know, places like here, like Java. This is your last chance. Free us or die. Stuff like that, you know? So I guess I should start with that. Then I have the palace. It's not movie accurate. Wow. I have a bunch of people here that shouldn't be here. Be criticized by that. I don't mind. So this is probably the centerpiece that you can shoot from every angle, and I really like it. Now I need to make room for the Razor Crest. Because I don't know where am I gonna put that, you know? And then I have another.
I know where you can put them.
Where?
You can hang it from the roof. Let it fry.
Well, I don't think I have. Yeah, I'm gonna show you right now. So this is hot. Like I was saying, recreating scenes has always been a passion of mine. And to answer to that question, I don't think I have room in the roof.
Oh, geez.
Because I ran out of room as well. Like I have
jeez.
Ships all over the place, because obviously. So yeah, I don't know about putting the Razor Crest there, because this hole is an actual thing. I really like the prequels. I'm a prequel guy. I always supported the prequels. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit dark, but here, you know, clones were a crazy, crazy era for modern toys. So there's a lot of clones in this section. I don't think I ever done this publicly, by the way. So you're getting like the first look of my collection.
Thank you.
And then I really like the vintage collection, so I'm going little by little in the wall. I have a little bit of everything. I'm trying to surf because I know that you have like a time restraint. Again, creating scenes is one of the things that I enjoy the most. It connects me to you know, to where I was.
Guys, there you go, guys. You just saw Guillermo's collection there. That was part one, and I look forward to seeing you in part two. May the force be with you.
May the force be with you.